Wagon trains eventually opened up this land, and there's something about them that's still in the American blood. Though today's travelers don't use the horses, they've certainly got the horsepower. Wagons roll!
Rolling, 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 though the streams are swollen.
I'd picked my camper van up in Albuquerque, but unlike the early pioneers who'd come looking for gold, I'd just come looking for the sights. If you're on the Santa Fe Trail, it's natural to assume that sooner or later, you'll come to Santa Fe. Those travelers of bygone days had scouts to show them around. I had the nearest thing, travel guide Charles Porter.
What sort of place is it to come for a holiday? It's an all-year-round resort, isn't it?
It really is. You've got skiing in the wintertime, rafting in the summer, Indian ruins, pueblos. It could take 2 days just to cover all the museums.
Well, come on and show me a bit more of it. We have a lot to see.
Let's do.
And there's a lot to buy as well. Santa Fe is teeming with art and craft work.
So how much would this cost me?
That'll be $45, sir.
$45, and that's silver?
That's sterling silver.
Yeah.
Put it around your neck.
And everybody wears these around here, don't
yes,
they?
Yes, that's in style.
Well, what do you think? Yeah, maybe you're right.
The Indians call this the land of the dancing sun. Once the land of the dancing sun captures your heart, it'll never let go.
Talking about never letting go.
The eyebrows.
Okay.
If you're ever going to hot air balloon, this is the place to do it. High mountains and open plains tend to create near-perfect conditions. £84 is what it'll cost you. You work out what that'll do to your pocket. I can only tell you, it'll certainly clear the mind. But there's a lot of ground to cover as well. Next stop, the Echo Amphitheater.
The Indians believed that these mountains could talk, that they had a sort of magical presence. I suppose the sort of place where your words could come back to haunt you.
You might have called 256-1041 Albuquerque or 983-1041 Santa Fe. I've got a pair of tickets. I'd be real happy to share with you.
The great thing about this type of holiday is you don't have to make it home at night, because home can be wherever you choose. How's about that for a view? If you don't like it, change it the next day.
Hey, it's not bad in here, is it? It can sleep up to 6 people, it's got its own washing and cooking facilities, and it's all fully air-conditioned. And it's really surprising just what you can pack into one of these.
You can order extras from cooking pots to garden chairs to mountain bikes. Now, it's quite easy to work up a head of steam about this trip, a train like everyone you've ever seen in a cowboy movie. This is Chama, the camper van's in the station car park, and I'm off on a day trip on board the Cumbres and Toltec Railroad.
The journey's 64 miles long and snakes between the South Rockies and the Colorado and New Mexico borders. And as for the view, well, you ain't seen nothing like this on the 715 to Paddington.
Come all year round as if you want to hear the story about a brave engineer. Casey Jones was the roller's name. On a 6-8 wheeler, boys, he rode to fame. Caller called Casey about a 4:30. He kissed his wife.
You never be too careful in these here parts.
Slammed in the cabin with his orders in his hand. Said, this is the trip to the promised land. Casey Jones. Climbed in a cabin, Casey Jones, orders in his hand.
When you hear the tooting of the whistle, it's Casey at the throttle of the Cannonball Express. You know, I used to hate that program.
From the iron horse, back to the covered wagon.
Depending on your route, it can, of course, be a long way between watering holes in New Mexico. So it's good advice to keep both your petrol tank and your fridge full, just in case.
But as is the way in the West, I went looking for trouble. A man's gotta do what a man's gotta do. It was time for a showdown with the mean chili. Doc Martens, no relation to the shoes, is said to dish up the hottest in the town of Taos.
Hot.
That was chili relleno. Now for green chili tortilla.
Very hot.
And finally, spicy enchiladas.
And
a man of his word, Doc Martin. You don't have to put your wagon in a circle, but you could try a campsite. There are plenty of them, and they're well equipped. Now, where next?
king of the road.
New Mexico is famed for its pueblos, Indian settlements which still house communities today. Because pueblos are actually people's homes, you'll be asked to abide by certain rules of behavior and to respect the Indian ceremonies.
We're often guilty of assuming in Britain that America never had much of a history before the landing of the Pilgrim Fathers around 1620. That is, until you come to a place like this.
These are the Buye Cliff Dwellings, part of the Santa Clara Pueblo. The ancestors of the Indians dancing lived here from the 12th to the 16th centuries. Visitors can wander around these ancient dwellings, soaking up the atmosphere in places like the Kiva, where the men would meet and pray. The splendor of dances like this can be seen on certain feast days. In ways like this, New Mexico is very old. And I can safely say, after visiting the land of enchantment, it won't just be the Indians who'll be beating the drum about it.
For further information, please write to Holiday Outings, BBC Television Centre, Wood Lane, London W12 7RJ, and please enclose a stamped addressed envelope. World Championship Athletics in 50 minutes here on BBC Two, with further live coverage from Stuttgart, including Sally Gunnell in the semi-final of the
500 Zügen, die hier in Zug Tag für Tag durchrasen sollen. Ein Tunnel muss her, fordern die Stadt und die Naturschützer. Das Umweltministerium sagt ja zum teuren Projekt, aber nur, wenn die Stadt sich finanziell beteiligt.
Hier sollen nämlich